It's our time. It's Oklahoma City time. It's very fitting. One of the songs that we played as we entered the auditorium here is by Van Halen, right here, right now. People are the most important element to a community and cities. Today, we're going to focus on our population and how that affects the real estate market. The growth of our people, both in numbers, diversity, skills, education, and culturally, are vital to the growth of our real estate industry. As you saw, we went through some stats about the world and the U.S. We are a very small portion of the world population, less than 0.02%. Our population is also only less than 0.5% of the United States population. But we are making an impact. At ORMF, an enzyme was found, is believed to be the cause of Alzheimer's, and is currently in research. We have made an impact, and we will continue to make an impact. I think that this statement here is very fitting, and it's by a man that I really respect, Harrison Lieb, and his dad. Look, that people are beginning to realize that we have to have something downtown, and gradually we'll have it. Maybe we'll have something beautiful. He said that in 1965, and look at where we are today. Our CBD, we have complete resurgence, and we'll get into a little bit of this here in just a little bit. We spent $2.2 billion on our MATS programs, including MATS 2, which is currently ongoing. We have, we've done our I-40, which is going to help reshape the growth of our downtown core for many, many years to come. We've done Project 180, which is, we're on the tail end of it, redoing every street in downtown, the central core of downtown Oklahoma City. We have a housing resurgence and many, many, many other things. We've had recent relocations. OE adding 2,000 jobs, and these are new to the state, and these are highly skilled, high-paying jobs. Mineral Resources, its recent relocation to Oklahoma City, they will move into their new facility when Devin moves out in the third and fourth quarter of this year. Those are highly skilled, high-paying jobs, and it's a growth-oriented company. Thank you, the types of companies that we want to grow forward. Expansion, Devon. We all know that the last 5 to 10 years they've rapidly been expanding and growing. They're a growth-oriented company. Again, those are high-skilled, high-paying jobs. Think about Devon also, as they grew into existing space, will help strengthen our office market and bring it to a new level. Chesapeake, again, rapid expansion, last 5 to 10 years. They're a growth-oriented company. They're continuing to expand. And they've actually expanded on their campus as well as outside the campus with significant acquisitions from office buildings. And the interesting thing about that is they continue to grow. They will buy an office building, and those tenants in those office buildings will then scatter to other buildings, so it helps strengthen the overall office market. SandRidge Energy. They are, again, a growth-oriented company. Been around 5+ years. They're expanding, again, highly skilled, high-paying jobs. The great thing about SandRidge's acquisition, they moved to the Carnegie headquarters. Many of us in this room thought that when Carnegie was bought by Anadarko, again, we're hit with a big blow that we're not going to be able to survive from. What do? We actually, that space never hit the market. SandRidge has grown to be one of the community leaders within our, one of the leaders within our community. Take a step back. We've been stuck with several other blows that have been very significant. Take OG&E, when they moved out of Corporate Tower, they hit 300,000 square feet in the 90s. That could have been a significant blow to us. Within 18 months, we had that space re-left. Flooding Foods, when they went bankrupt, they had 600,000 square feet. Some of you guys have heard me say these things before, but I think it's good to reinforce them. Flooding Foods had 600,000 square feet. When they went away, how would we backfill that space? We did it in less than 18 months. General Motors, talking from an industrial standpoint, they when they ceased operations, well, we all thought, gosh, what are we going to do with that? Boom, Tinker expands. I can't remember if it's a Goodrich or Goodyear facility. When that hit the market, well over 1 million square feet, what are we going to do with that? Co-op took half of it. They've got a thriving business talking about expansion, and that's been repurposed. And Randy Lace will talk a little bit about that later. tremendous amount of accolades. And some of them pop up on the screen, and they'll continue to come. People are watching us. Let's show them that we belong.